Good morning, everyone, and welcome to On the Couch with Rosanna Baptist Church. Hi, I'm Phil Sporton, and as always, I'm here with our senior pastor, David Buesnel. Good day, David.
Good morning, Phil. How are you? How's life down at Aries?
Very nice, thank you. Very nice. It's a bit crisp, but very nice.
Trip down to the beach coming up, I guess.
Yes, that's right.
Well, Phil, as people can see from our background, it's Anzac Day, and I think a lot about Anzac Day on and off, and it's probably the most revered day in the Australian calendar, I think, for the Australian public. It trumps Good Friday, and I have a feeling that Anzac Day is our secular sacred day of remembrance. And so, Phil, I ask you, what does Anzac Day mean to you?
Well, I think the fields of poppies that in our background today are very pertinent for me, because I actually went to Flanders, to France, and looked over the World War I battlefields and was just taken aback by the red poppies. They were in flower. And it just sort of strikes you about the tragedy of war, the loss of all these wonderful people. We don't celebrate war, but we do celebrate those who've gone before us that we might enjoy the life that we live.
Yeah. I guess I've never been not aware of Anzac Day. My father was an ex-serviceman, and he was in the army until he broke his neck, and then I was part of the Salvation Army, and soon as I was old enough, about 15, to join the Salvation Army, and every Anzac Day we would participate in a dawn service, and then, you know, sometimes we would play at the service of remembrance of the cross of sacrifice in Adelaide. And I've lost count of the number of times I've heard, greater love has no man than this, than he lay down his life for his friend. Every time that statement's been made, and that's sort of certainly our text there at the back of us on the screen. But Phil, I want to really look at that after our reading. So if you're ready to read, perhaps you could bring us the reading.
Okay, off to the reading. Today's reading comes from the book of John, chapter 15, verses 9 to 17. I have loved you even as the Father has loved me. Remain in my love. When you obey my commandments, you remain in my love, just as I obey my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you these things so that you will be filled with my joy. Yes, your joy will overflow. This is my commandment. Love each other in the same way I have loved you. There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you slaves, because a master doesn't confide in his slaves. Now you are my friends, since I have told you everything the Father told me. You didn't choose me. I chose you. I appointed you to go and produce lasting fruit, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask for using my name. This is my command. Love each other.
Well, thanks, Phil. You know, I'm a believer in setting a context for the scriptures and looking at the scriptures in their context. And if we look at this one, and I put these statements together, Jesus says, love each other in the same way I have loved you. There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. And if you read them together in the context of that whole passage, Jesus is actually talking about himself. Mm-hmm. He's talking about him laying down his life. And he's actually saying there that he lays down his life out of love for his friends. He's giving his life for them, for his friends. And who do you think are his friends, Phil?
That would be us, hopefully.
It would be everybody. He put it, laid down his life for everybody. And he's hoping to accomplish something for them. So if you look at all of those things together there, Phil, how does that speak to you of sacrifice?
Well, so obviously laying one's life down is the ultimate sacrifice. But in doing that, we get the ultimate gift, it's more than the sacrifice. It's the gift, and the gift of eternal life through that sacrifice.
Exactly right. Exactly right. I'm not denying the value of, people, soldiers laying down their lives for their friends. And part of the moving aspect of Anzac Day for me is just watching the old diggers as they remember their mates who didn't come back, and how they paid a sacrifice and they paid the ultimate price. But that's not really what we're about here. It becomes apparent if we look at that text that Jesus is inviting us to love others as Jesus loves us, right? And them. Herein is a great secret. To lay down one's life for another effectively means a few things, and here they are, Phil. It means that we will serve others in humility to help them rise up in truth and love. It means we will willingly place the interests of other people before our own. It means that we will give life to others, and that may mean accepting difficulties, our personal difficulties, danger, and even death, so that they may live and grow in love. And it also means, Phil, that we live in communion with others and transmit to them the life and love of Jesus. Now, Phil, I've got a question here for you. Based on that call to love and to lay down our life for others, what would happen if that every person on the face of the earth, every leader, every person on the face of the earth chose to live like that? What would be the result? The
result would be no conflict, and therefore there would be no more people after the current to march in Anzac Day.
We'd sort of run out of the arms race. We'd run out of selfishness. There'd be no one nation wanting to dominate another nation. And of course, you know, one of the other sides of war that we don't talk about really all that much is that the innocent people that suffer through conflict, through no fault of their own, horrendous things done in the name of the war. And I think it would be wonderful if we could actually grasp this concept of how to live, laying down our life for the other. The other is always most important, and that's what Jesus came to show us. So I would suggest and encourage our readers and hearers today, that it's a worthwhile consideration to live as Jesus invites us to live, to put others before ourselves, and to see the difference that will make. It makes a huge difference for me, and it will make a huge difference for the people that I come in contact with. So that's my take on Anzac Day and, laying down your life for your friends. I think it's a very deep concept and one that we need to really try hard to grasp and live out.
Thank you, David. And I absolutely agree. And shall we close in prayer?
Let's pray. Let's close in prayer. Let's pray. All glory and honour be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks today, and we praise you for your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who was born of Mary and lived as one of us. By his death on the cross and rising to new life, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin, forgiving his killers and reconciling us to each other and to you. He breathed the Holy Spirit on his disciples and sent them out to befriend with peace and justice the people of every language, every race, every nation, and every gender. Therefore, with all the company of heaven, today we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Phil.
And thank you, David. And thank you, everyone, for joining us on the couch this week. I hope you've enjoyed our little journey on the Anzacs. And have a great Anzac Day. And we'll see you all next week.
Thank you. Bless you. See you soon.
Bye for now, and God bless.